वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट हाइब्रिड मेन. ओके, सो नॉर्मल मेन्यू इज अ पॉपअप. इट कंटेन्स अ मेन्यू एंड इट कंटेन्स मेन्यू आइटम. सो इट इज अ कंपोजिट डिजाइन पैटर्न. मेन्यू कैन कंपोज इट्सेल्फ एंड इट कैन कंपोज लीफ आइटम दैट इज मेन्यू आइटम. मेन्यू आइटम इज अ बटन. सो फ्रॉम डिजाइन पर्सपेक्टिव इट इज अ कंपोजिट स्ट्रक्चरल डिजाइन पैटर्न, अ स्ट्रक्चरल कंपोजिट डिजाइन पैटर्न. मेन्यू हैज मेन्यू and menu has menu items. Okay, what is the problem here? Menu is not clickable. If you hover over a menu or click on a menu, it will bring a pop-up window, and in pop-up window you have some menu and menu item. There are scenarios where we don't need a menu. I mean, there are scenario where I would rather say where we need a menu which would bring a pop-up if we hover upon it, and it should be clickable. I have a menu, it brings a pop-up. Inside that I have menu items, that is a button, and other sub-menus. If I hover over a menu, it brings a pop-up on right side or left side, but it's not clickable. In hybrid menu it should be clickable. So that is the idea. So how we can bring hybrid menu? So hybrid menu in composite design pattern, if we see, then what the requirement is, a menu composes a menu and menu composes menu item. Menu should be clickable. That is the requirement. So if we see design, then we can do something in the menu item. So menu item should compose menu also, because menu is no way it is clickable. We cannot derive from menu and make it clickable, not possible. If we want a menu to be clickable, then is a kind of, we can do some kind of hiding something or kind of producing something different thing in front. So menu contains menu item. We can falsify it by menu contains, if we want a menu which is hybrid and it should be clickable also. If I hover over a menu, then it brings a pop-up on right side or left side, but if I click on menu, then it should trigger a custom event. That is the idea. And it is required, like I have menu items like A, B, C, D, and if I want to have a menu that will bring all these menu items, what name I am going to put there? Among A, B, C, D, A is well enough to make people understand that BCD is following it. Why to waste one place? I can have A, that is, if I hover over A, it would bring BCD, and A should be clickable. So this way we save a lot, one thing. Second thing is that no need to place too many things in menu. It becomes very small. So that is the idea. So from the implementation point of view, menu contains menu item and menu. If menu is required to be a hybrid menu, then that would be falsified by another menu item, since menu item is clickable. So menu item, we can have a custom menu item that derives from menu item and it is clickable. Then we can catch hover event over the menu item, and then it would actually bring the another menu. A menu item would behave like a menu. If we hover over a menu item, it would bring another menu which has a pop-up. So in design pattern, if we see, menu contains menu, menu compose menu item. hybrid menu item would compose menu. So this is the change we will make the in the composite design pattern. Then we can have a hybrid menu where menus are clickable, saving lot of graphics items, and it is pretty simple to see. So that we'll see. We are in discussion about hybrid menu in QML. This is Linux Mint. There is no hybrid menu in QML as such, but we'll see if we can implement such. What is hybrid menu? We'll talk. We'll go point by point. What is a normal menu and what is problem? Normal menu can provide a pop-up, but it cannot be triggered on it itself. That is problem with normal menu, and this creates a lot. It's extra menu item is floated in this fashion that may not be required. Hybrid menu can be triggered, and thus is this number of menu items get reduced, and it saves the spaces. What is hybrid menu? If I have a menu like this, then this menu item actually brings a new menu. So this is a menu, submenu. This is a menu item. This is a menu item. This is a submenu. And hovering over it or clicking over it whatsoever, it brings a pop-up window. And this pop-up window contains two menu items. This is not clickable. So it eats up a space of a menu item. This is what this says. It causes extra abstract menu item to be floated. It can be minimized in hybrid menu. If it is a hybrid menu, so right now it cannot be clicked. This cannot be clicked. It cannot trigger an event. But if it is a hybrid menu, it can be clicked and it would trigger an event. That is the concept. So this would save up space. Typically, like, I don't need open and open recent. So one will become redundant, and just clicking on open recent would bring a new menu. It would bring a file dialog. So this is concept of hybrid menu. Let's see menu hierarchy. Menu is pop-up, and it derives from Qt object. Whereas menu item is a button, is a control, and it is an item. So these are the two things, menu and menu item. Abstract button is a control, and it provides a event called clicked. Menu item provides separate event called triggered. So we have two, one is clicked and one is triggered. And clicking on menu, since it is not a button, it is actually not clickable. It brings a pop-up window on which abstract buttons or menu item can be placed. Hybrid menu. So normal menu, if we see the design, a menu composes, so it follows composite design, a structural design pattern, composite structural design patterns. A menu compose other menu. A menu composes menu items. A menu item is a leaf item, and it doesn't compose any other menu item, neither it compose any menu. Menu can compose a menu, menu can compose a menu. So this is the design of a normal menu. Now
In hybrid menu, that is the design we are proposing, menu item now can compose menu. So this is hybrid menu. A menu item, now there is a proposal that it would now compose a menu, 1:1. One menu item can compose only one menu. A menu can contain many menu items, and menu can compose many submenus. But a menu item cannot compose a menu item, but it can compose a menu, only one. So this is the design that we are proposing. If we see the implementation, custom menu item, so it can be multi-layer, single layer, multi-layer. Single layer means one menu has one submenu that is clickable. Otherwise, if it is not clickable, then someone can bring as many as submenus, but to any level. But clickable, a custom menu item. So menu item is replaced by custom menu item. And there is a new property called custom submenu. This property is now a menu, and triggered event handling is anyway there. This is custom menu item. A custom menu item has on triggered, a menu item has one on triggered slot. It brings a new property, that is custom submenu. Custom submenu is a menu. This is extra. That makes a menu item hybrid. Whereas in multi-layer, where there are many levels, custom submenu will also be a custom menu. So custom menu item and custom menu. First we'll see custom menu item to single layer, and then custom menu as multi-layer. So what are the changes now? We had new, open, recent, and open. If we see the slide, new, open, recent, and open. This is the typical menu, and now it is modified to new and open. This is the change. Someone can click on it. It will bring the open. If someone clicks on it, it will bring a dialog box. Someone hover over it, then it would bring file 1 and file 2, a pop-up. So it saves a space. Now someone has to bother only about two menu items in the file menu. This saves a lot of space. So it is clickable now. Someone can click. Cannot click, so that is no more the limitation. Someone can click over it. Someone can go to multi-layer in the sense that there is only one new, and hovering over it would bring open. Open is clickable. New is clickable. Hovering over open would bring the recent open files. So now here in the main menu is only one. In single layer, main menu is two. Otherwise it is three. So this is far better. Single layer, only two. And then, so in the main menu, what someone clicks on, we can add so many menu items now, it's possible. Otherwise, it would hog the space. So that is the scenario. Okay, so first we develop the single layer, and then we'll develop the multi-layer. Okay, so we'll start. We'll create a directory, hybrid menu, and it's empty. Okay, so we'll code the custom menu item first, and we'll see how it works. So we'll bring the custom menu architecture. menu item. So menu item is derived from abstract button and it derives from control, which is item and qt object. If we see menu item, then there are arrow highlighted, menu, submenu and triggered. So menu is the menu in which menu item exists, and arrow is the arrow what if we right click, here it is not there. If we right click, then we can see arrow on right side, so that we can draw. So we'll draw arrow and then we'll write a code for. So idea here is that if I right click and get a menu and it brings a sub menu, then coming back to any menu item should delete the sub menu. Like here, if I right click and I get a sub menu, and if I come back, then sub menu pop up should go away. So we need to catch the slot for that. Custom menu item dot QML import qt quick import qt quick dot controls. We derive from menu item. ID is button ID. We'll put a default text string. Custom menu item like this. Okay, so property that is custom sub menu, and it is this. So this is the code. Now we are writing for a single layer first. So in single layer, if I have menu, then menu will become it will assign to a property called custom submenu, and it would be wrapped up by custom menu item. So this is what we are writing, property where custom submenu undefined. Now arrow is canvas. So canvas can be, there is a presentation on canvas already. Parent dot width minus width. Place it width. Place it height. Button ID dot. Visible if custom sub menu equal to undefined, visible false, otherwise it is true. On paint, context will get the context 2D. Context dot fill style equal to highlighted, otherwise it would be green. So this, we are drawing the arrow in this fashion. Context move to 0 height by 3. Context line to width by 3. Height by 2. Context line to 0 height into 2 by 3. And we'll close the. So these descriptions are already available in the Canvas presentation that can be watched. So context we receive, and fill style is, if it is highlighted, then move to here, line 2, close path fill, on paint is over, arrow is over. Now we'll override on clicked so that mouse it should go away. I think we don't need mouse. Let p menu equal to menu, while p menu dot parent dot menu not equal to undefined, and menu dot p menu dot parent dot menu not equal to p menu. Pmenu dot close. Pmenu equal to pmenu dot parent dot menu. Pmenu dot close. Okay, so this is the code. For on clicked, we'll do indentation a little bit. Now we'll code for the connections for index change. Okay, so here menu, if we see menu derives from pop-up and QT object. Now if we see a menu, there is current index. So current index would change if we hover over the menu items. So target is button id dot menu, function on current index change. If button id dot custom submenu not equal to undefined and not button id dot custom submenu dot opened. Okay, so we are trying to open it. And button id dot menu dot item at button id dot menu current index button id and button id dot menu dot current index greater than, so it is little big. What we are trying to do is button id custom submenu is not undefined, so submenu is there. Button id custom submenu opened, so it is not opened. And button id menu item at button id menu current index equal to, so it's me. And current index is greater than 0. If this is the case, then this is a perfect candidate to open it. So we'll specify xy coordinate button id dot custom submenu dot x equal to button id dot width, id dot custom submenu dot y equal to 0, and button id dot array dot request pend, button id custom submenu dot open. Else if button id custom submenu not equal to undefined and button id custom submenu dot opened. Now we are in phase to close it, and button id dot menu item at button id menu dot current index not equal to button id and button id dot menu dot current index greater than equal to 0. So if this is the case, then button id dot arrow dot pend request button id custom sub menu dot close. Okay, we'll see the file again. Menu item, and then we are setting the canvas, and then on click, then we are closing. If any menu item is clicked, then menu should go away. Complete menu should go away. That is the idea. And after that, we have connections, and on current index change, then we have to open it. And if it is opened already and it's not me, it is already open and it's not me, and current index is valid, then we would close it. Okay, so connections function if. Now this is for function connections and this is for menu item. So we have written the code. Let's see if it works. We'll write a test case and we'll see. So now the file are custom menu item.qml. We'll have one test.qml import qt quick. Import qt quick dot controls a rectangle width 800 height 400 mouse area anchors dot fill parent accepted buttons. Okay, accepted buttons. on clicked mouse, if mouse dot button equal to qt right button, if this is the case, then we'll set the xy coordinate. So it would be like menu id dot x equal to mouse dot x, menu id dot y equal to mouse dot y. Rectangle width mouse area accepted buttons on clicked, if okay, so if on clicked mouse area. Now we'd add a menu ID is menu ID, and then it has menu item text. We can put something kind of new, and that's it. Then it has sub menu, title is some open recent, the way it is in design. Menu item text would be some file one, these are the recent files. Menu item again text would be file two. Okay, we can have one more menu item. Text is open. Menu is over. And so we'll see our test. Rectangle anchors fill parent and accepted buttons are right button. If someone clicks and it is right button, then menu ID need to be brought in, menu ID dot open mouse, and we have menu ID new, open recent, menu item. Okay, so this is without custom menu. Now we'll copy the main.py, that is generic main.py. So this is py side 6. So according to py side 6, main.py is written. This would call the either quick view or QML application engine based upon the test case. So we'll execute it. Oh, it comes. If I right click, I'm getting the menu. This is the arrow. This is black arrow. If I place, then it becomes white. And this is pop-up menu. Pop-up menu and file 1 and file 2 are menu items. Two menu items are there, new and open. But it is not clickable. If I click on new, it goes away. If I click on open, it goes away. These are menu items. If I click on file, it goes away. File 2, it goes away. If I click on open recent, it doesn't go away. So this is not a menu item. This is menu. So it is kind of hogging some space. May not be required. So we'll change the code as per the design. So first, we'll place the custom menu item, and as per the design, Only open is sufficient. Open recent is not required. If we click on open, it should come. Otherwise, hovering over would bring file 1 and file 2. So this is the design. Now menu is nice. This sub menu would change now. So here it will become menu item. Custom menu item, whatever we have received. And here custom sub menu is a property. Custom sub menu is in property and menu would come here. This is the architecture. So this is how we have to implement custom menu item. So custom menu item would get this as text. And open recent would go away, not required. Just open is enough. And this open is not required. And it should be clickable now. So it should trigger something. So I can just say on triggered. On triggered console.log open triggered. So it should trigger something. Then on other side it should show sub menu also. So this is hybrid menu. Okay, so we'll bring it again. Okay, nothing comes. Custom menu highlighted is not defined. Still not coming. Type a property line 2. Line 2. We'll try again. Oh, it comes. Now it is green. And new is clickable. If I hover over open, okay, it should bring pop-up window here and it should be clickable. So it is clickable. Okay, button ID custom sub menu dot open request pent. Type error. Property where custom sub menu. Custom sub menu. Equal to undefined. Equal to undefined custom sub menu. Okay, so it is saying undefined. Okay, so we'll see again. Request pend. Request pend. Okay, so what it is? Okay, so it is request. Request pend. Request pend, request pend. We'll try again. Okay, so it is better. Now it is a button, so it is clickable, and we can see it is triggered. This is hybrid menu. So hybrid menu means a menu, a sub menu that is clickable, and all these are also working. Okay, so they should close this stuff, but it's not closing. It is clickable though, so we'll fix that also. Okay, on click pmenu equal to menu, while pmenu parent dot menu not equal to undefined, and pmenu parent menu not equal to pmenu, pmenu close, pmenu. Okay, so it is not closing because that is not custom menu, so we'll make it custom menu. So these guys should be custom menu, so that they should follow our logic. Custom menu. Now it should be okay. So we'll bring it again. Python 3 main. Okay, it goes away. Now everything is clickable. New is clickable. Open is clickable. It is triggering. So this is hybrid menu, and it is for one layer. Now idea is that we can bring in for multi-layer. Okay, so we have one example that is that we have already written in the menu session. We have already one example. If I right click, and we can really open a file, and file comes in here, and we can type in hello world. Then recent file comes here, whatever is opened, I can click on it, it comes and open another file. Now recent file comes as main.py, my main. So this is a working example we have. Now recent is file.io. I can click on main and it changes. So this is the menu already available and code is there to show. Same thing. Now we'll copy here and we'll see kind of working example. Now we'll go to here and we'll copy menu, file IO, these are required, and regular expression are required. Otherwise we'll copy for main.py would be different because it has to export file IO and those things, and Mr. Menu we would copy. Now we'll see my menu.qml. It is exactly same what we have written. So we'll do the changes now. Here we'll say custom menu item, and this we'll copy here as text. Open recent. So we'll say open, and now these become custom menu item. Custom menu item, and we don't need this guy now because we are, it is becoming redundant now. So we would copy this code there on triggered. So custom menu now has triggering. So this would become a custom sub menu, and these are the code. So we can say +15. Okay, so custom sub menu, custom menu item 1, custom menu item 2, this is for here. We are following the design, and the menu which was there, it is now becoming a attribute to custom sub menu and custom menu item coming as a wrapper, so that it should be clickable. If I trigger it, it should do the same function, otherwise it is same. So we'll execute this in our scenario now. Now we have these many files. Okay, test we will not execute. Instead of that, this is my menu.qml. These files for regular expression and file IO and custom menu item we have written. Python 3 main. Okay, it comes in. If I right click, green color is coming, this is hybrid, and if I click on open, it brings a dialog box. I can click on any file and it comes. File IO is the more latest one. If I click again, we are getting my menu. Now there are two. If I click on file IO comes. I can open a new one. Hello world. Now if I click on file, then same thing should happen. If I click on my menu should come. And if I click on file IO should come. So hybrid menu is working. Open is clickable, and if I hover over open, then these are coming. Otherwise, it is clickable. All are clickable now. There is no wastage of menu. This is clickable. This is clickable. This is clickable. And new is clickable. Same thing we can get from here. So this is about single level hybrid menu we talked about. We'll talk about multi-layer. So in multi-layer, this menu